Hello everyone, here we are learning how to find missing sides of a right angle triangle by using Pythagoras theorem and trigonometrical ratios. In part 1, we are using Pythagoras theorem. Before that, we should be able to find out what is adjacent, opposite and hypotenuse. Here in the right angle triangle, always opposite to 90 degree will be hypotenuse, that is slanting line, and that horizontal line, the sleeping line, is generally known as adjacent, and the standing line we can consider as opposite. Here we have two diagrams. In diagram 1, we have only 90 degree. There is no other angle is given. So we can easily say 90 degree opposite is hypotenuse and the horizontal line is adjacent and the vertical line is opposite side. In example 2, along with 90, we have one more angle, 70 degree. So whenever we have other angle with 90 degree, that particular line will consider as adjacent. The rest of the line will be opposite and hypotenuse. In right angle triangle, hypotenuse will be the longest side. Pythagoras theorem says hypotenuse square is equal to opposite square plus adjacent square. If we need to find out any particular side, we have to square root. Then we can get the answer. In question 1, in this diagram, find y with one decimal place correction. Before that, we should know what is adjacent, opposite and hypotenuse. This is 90 degree. 90 degree opposite side is y, which is known as hypotenuse. And this horizontal line will be adjacent and the vertical line will be opposite. We can apply Pythagoras theorem. Hypotenuse square is equal to opposite square plus adjacent square. Hypotenuse is known as y, y square. Opposite is 2.5 plus adjacent is 1.5 square. Value of 2.5 square is 6.25. 1.5 square is 2.25. Adding these two values, we are getting 8.5, which is y square. We need to find y. So we have to apply square root on both sides. Y is equal to 2.9154. We need the answer. With one dp correction, it will be 2.9, and the unit is mentioned meter, so we can say y equal to 2.9 meter. In question 2, a rhombus has sides of length 52 millimeter. The length of the shorter diagonal is 40 millimeter. Then find the length of the longer diagonal. Hint, we have to make the diagram first. We can draw the rhombus first of all. Here in this rhombus, the property is all the four sides are equal. So they have given the side is 52 millimeter. This is 52, so that all the four sides will be 52 only. And the shorter diagonal is 40 millimeter. This is shorter and this is longer. So the shorter diagonal is 40 millimeter, which we can dividing as 20 and 20. Here we are able to getting a right angle triangle, which is having 20 and 52. So this will be the required length. In this diagram, opposite to 90 degree is 52, which is known as hypotenuse. And this will be adjacent and this will be opposite. We are applying same Pythagoras theorem. Hypotenuse square is equal to opposite square plus adjacent square. Hypotenuse is given 52. Opposite is unknown. We can assume that is x. So x square plus adjacent will be 20 square. Rearranging with x as subject, we are getting 52 square minus 20 square equal to x square. Means we are moving this positive 20 square to left side. Whenever you are moving the terms, the sign will get changed. Here 52 square giving 2704 minus 20 square 400. By subtracting these two numbers, 2304 is equal to x square. Again, we have to apply square root. Square root of 2304 will be 48. X is known as 48. X is only a part, the vertical part, that is 48. But the longer diagonal is going towards down, means we have two length like this. So we can say longer diagonal is equal to, this is longer diagonal. If this part is 48, the down one is also 48, which means 96, and the unit is millimeter is given. We can say 96 millimeter. Thanks for watching this. If you have any doubt in some particular chapters, you can comment. I'll try to upload it in the next video. Thank you.